So it's now 2012, and there have been prophecies supposedly that the world's coming to an end in December of 2012. Supposedly, the Mayan calendar is going to run out, which actually scholars have debunked a long time ago. But there's a lot of different hucksters, charlatans, cult leaders who are prophesying doomsday, Armageddon, as a device to generate fear in order to recruit people into their particular groups. And with the current economic stresses and chronic sleep deprivation and pervasive information overload, there's a whole new generation that has grown up ignorant of the major cult stories that people of my generation are used to, the Charles Manson, the People's Temple, the Waco, the Heaven's Gate, the Om Shinrikyo sarin gassing. And so really what's happening right now on the internet is that groups are using their manpower to manipulate search engines, to create all kinds of faux websites, to infiltrate discussion groups, to actually hack into websites of critics and former members, suing critics and former members for posting material against them. In other words, it's the wild, wild west on the internet. And whereas when the internet first started in the mid-90s, it was a fantastic tool for sharing critical information about cults, and cults hated that. Now cults have adapted to the times, hired top internet marketing companies, and are manipulating things to only have the best entries coming up in the first 10 or 20 hits on Google or whatever. They have people going on Wikipedia and doing puff pieces on themselves and trying to take off any critical information on Wikipedia. And it really is essential that there are more student activists as well as middle-aged and elderly activists who are advocating a more sophisticated consumer awareness that a lot of the worst destructive organizations and people just change names and they reinvent themselves and start businesses again, even though they've been maybe convicted of fraud or they've lost multi-million dollar lawsuits. And of course, groups who use celebrities like Scientology, for example, even though they have been described in great detail in the legal system as a destructive mind control group. And major media outlets like Time did a cover story in 1991. They've used their wealth to make the media outlets afraid to cover any controversial story. So what's happening now, in my view, is the combination of the vulnerability factors of the general population, the stresses that exist in the modern world, and the increasing sophistication of psychology, particularly social psychology, on how to influence people's minds and how to influence their behavior. It's creating a perfect storm where we're more vulnerable than ever to some charismatic, persuasive voice that's going to give hope and direction. So in my work, I hear from people all over the world who have a loved one involved with a Korean karate cult, for example, or some pseudo-Christian group, or some neo-Buddhist group, or an atheist group, or I'm hearing a lot from people who talk about their brother or their sister marrying someone, and now that they've cut themselves off from the entire family. I've heard of people turning over their trust funds to individuals who claim that they're psychics and mediums. The thing that scares me the most is if you go on Google and do a search for hypnosis plus sex, there's hundreds of websites that will teach covert hypnotic techniques on how to rape other people for your own gratification. And even though I've pitched the story to major media for at least 10 years, no one wants to do that story. And all I can say is that they're afraid to engage their legal team and have a very expensive lawsuit because but people are being harmed, and these techniques really do exist. So what I really want to say to everybody is, hey, wake up. Our freedom is precious. Our minds are precious. Learn to be a good consumer. Find out the name of the group, the name of the leader, research its history. Don't just be dependent on the recruiter to tell you information. Go to portals like my website, freedomofmind.com, and see if they're listed. And if they're not listed, it doesn't mean they're okay. It just means that they're not up on the internet for some reason. We're a small organization. And the most important thing is to educate yourself and protect your mind. It's precious. Thank you.